Hallelujah. Let us give God some praise this morning. I want to welcome everyone here this morning to our church service. We are coming to you from the New Testament Church of God in Calder, where Pastor Carson Ferdinand is our pastor, and presently he's on vacation, but we are thanking God that we are going to see him today. And our assistant pastor is Minister Diana C. Williams. We want to thank God for our pastor and his family who are on vacation, and we hope that they are having a restful time. Stand with me this morning as we give God some praise and some glory all around this place this morning, for he is wonderful. God has been with us in our journey, and I can tell you something, that he has no plans to leave us, because he promised that he would always be with us. Hallelujah. Let us give God some praise and thanks. Sometimes you might be going through some difficult times. You might be going through some stuff today. You might be celebrating today. Let us give God some praise and some thanks for what he is doing and what he's about to do. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. I want to welcome those who are viewing us by way of YouTube. We want to thank you for viewing, Sister Edwards, and the rest of our folks in Canada. We want to thank our good friends in Barbados, in the BVI, in the United States of America, those folks who are viewing and saying to us that they are looking at our service and they are enjoying the presence of God, what God is doing in this place. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. At this time, I'm going to call on Minister Diana C. Williams to do our opening prayer this morning. Praise God.
Hallelujah. We give you praise, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We magnify your name, Jesus. Your word says, let everything that had breath praise the Lord. So we praise you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We magnify you, Lord. You are King of Kings, you are Lord of Lords. You are the mighty God, the everlasting Father, our shield and our buckler. We thank you, Father God, that you are the rose of Sharon. You are the lily of the valley. You are the bright and morning star. You are the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Oh God, we just praise you. We just worship you, Lord. We thank you that you have put us to sleep last night, and you have awakened us to see a brand new day, all the way from eternity. Many would have gone to sleep last night and didn't awake to see a new day, but we are alive and well. Oh God, we give you praise. Oh God, we worship you, for great is your faithfulness. Your mercies are renewed every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. And oh God, we thank you for redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ. We thank you we are no ordinary citizens. We are not ordinary people. We are a peculiar people. Lord, we thank you that we are a royal priesthood. And we praise you, God, that you have made us to show forth your praises. So, Holy Spirit of the living God, you live in us. And we thank you for your presence here with us. Because you said where two or three are gathered, you are in the midst. And we are more than two or three. So we give you praise. And we bless your name. Holy Spirit of the living God, we ask you to take over in our midst this morning. Let your Shekinah glory fill this tabernacle, oh God. Let there be transformation in the name of Jesus, in everything that is going to be said and done, in the worship, O God. Let worship be done under the anointing of the Holy Spirit, O God. O God, the preaching of your word, let it be done under the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Let your word find lodging places in the heart of your people, O God. And they will be transformed, O God. They will be changed from glory to glory. And Lord of hosts, we ask you to let your kingdom come and your will be done in Jesus' holy name. Amen. And let the church say, amen. Praise.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give God the glory. I'm telling you this morning, I got up this morning and I said, thank you, Jesus, for having me on the wake-up list today. And not only that, we are glad that we can see. Last evening, I met a friend of mine and I inquired about her husband after we spoke and so on. I asked about her husband and she said to me, he is still waiting on his eyes to open. Hallelujah. Praise God. She has hope that one day he will see. And I know that a lot of us can see. We have a lot of things to thank God for today. Hallelujah. But you know what? We are going to break up Satan this morning. We are going to bind up the forces of hell today. And before I go into that song, I want to invite our worship team to join me up here this morning. Let us welcome them as they come. I want to welcome our musicians. Hallelujah. We thank God for these brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. And we are going to bind up the forces of hell before we have our scripture reading this morning. We are binding the forces of hell. Satan's weapon cannot prevail. The church is alive, doing well, burning up the strongholds of hell. We are binding the forces of hell. And if we're going to do something, we have to mean it this morning. Amen? We have to mean it this morning. Hallelujah. We have to confront the enemy this morning and tell him who is in charge. Tell him that Jesus is in charge and he has no place here this morning. Hallelujah. At this time, we'll have our scripture reading. Scripture reading will be a congregational reading. And it will be taken from Luke chapter 6. Luke chapter 6. And we'll be reading verse 27 and 28 together. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 6. 27 and 28. Amen. If you found it, hallelujah. It says, but I say unto you, which hear, love your enemies, do good to them that hate you, bless them that curse you, and pray for them which despisefully use you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. And that's a command from God this morning. Hallelujah. I now would like to welcome our pastor who just joined us. Hallelujah. Let us give God praise and thanks for him. We understand that he's on holidays, he's on vacation, but Pastor has seen it fit to be with us today because we have asked him to join us to carry out a certain function which you will hear about a little later. I want to welcome those who have just joined us by way of YouTube, and otherwise, welcome all our visitors. We see some visitors in our midst. We want to welcome you. We love you. We love you with a great call to welcome and love. And at this time, I'll invite the devotion leader to come forward and lead us into some real songs of praise this morning.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord some praise this morning. Hallelujah. We are happy to be in the presence of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
Holiness. Holiness is what I long for. Holiness is what I need.
Sing holiness again with me this morning. Holiness.
Holiness. Holiness is what I long for.
Holiness is what we need.
Holiness is what I need. Holiness. Holiness is what you want.
The Lord to take our hands
and take my hand. Righteousness is what you want from me.
Save my heart, Jesus, and form it.
Oh, and save my heart and form it. Save my mind, transform it. Save my
my heart
and for me.
Jesus.
To yours, to yours, O Lord.
To yours.
To yours, to yours, O Lord.
Hallelujah. Take my heart and form it to yours, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord, you've done so much for me, Jesus, and I cannot tell it all. Hallelujah. If you know the Lord has done so much for you, sing this song lustfully to his name. Hallelujah.
You've done so much for me, I cannot tell it all.
Now run,
Now run,
great is our God. Can somebody tell me how great is our God? Hallelujah.
The splendor of the King, Lord in majesty, all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wrapped himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembled at his voice, and trembled at his voice.
Above all names.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh God, you are great.
Hallelujah. We're going to take up the morning tithes and offering. Hallelujah. Morning tithes and offering. Ushers, can you get ready? As he's saying, come see what the Lord has done for me.
The Lord has done for me. Come see what a mighty God he is. Come see what the Lord has done for me. Come see what a mighty God he is.
There was a tumbling,
there was a tumbling,
there was a tumbling down,
oh, praise his holy name.
There was a tumbling,
there was a tumbling,
there was a tumbling down, Lord, praise his holy name.
Come see what the Lord has done for me.
Come see what a mighty God he is.
Come see what the Lord has done for me.
Come see what a mighty God he is.
The walls are tumbling,
the walls are tumbling. tumbling. The walls are tumbling down, Lord, praise His holy name. The walls are tumbling. The walls are tumbling. The walls are tumbling down, Lord, praise His holy name. He's a miracle working God. My God is a wonder, a miracle worker. He's a miracle working God.
He's a miracle.
Oh, he's a miracle working God. He's a miracle working God.
Oh, God is a wonder.
He's a miracle.
Oh, he's a miracle working God.
He's a miracle working God.
Oh, God is a wonder.
Come see what a mighty God he is.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. As we all bow our heads this morning, Lord Jesus, we want to thank you, Lord. We lift up your holy name this morning, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for bringing us out this morning, Lord Jesus, for blessing us, Lord God, and giving us the opportunity to give back to your house, Lord Jesus. Lord, as we bring this offering before you, we pray, Lord God, that you will bless it. Sanctify it, Lord God, and bring it forth, Lord God, to your kingdom, Lord Jesus, to do great things, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for all the hands who are able to give this morning, Lord Jesus. And we pray, Lord God, for your saints, Lord Jesus, that when they come again, they will be able to give again unto you, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, a mighty blessing over their lives, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that you'll keep them, Lord God, that you'll keep your household, Lord Jesus. We pray, Lord God, that you'll cover each and every one of us, Lord God, as we even enter out into the world this week. We thank you, Lord God, and we put all this in your name, in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to sing What a Fellowship. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, God.
Praise God.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way. Leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day. Leaning on the everlasting arms, leading, leading, safe and secure from all alarms. Leading, leading, leading on the everlasting arms. What a light to tread, what a light to fear. Leaning on the everlasting arms. I have tested peace with my love so led. Leaning on the everlasting arms.
Leaning,
leaning, leaning. Safe and secure from all alarms.
Leaning,
leaning, leaning. Leaning on the everlasting arms. From
next song would be You Are Able. Praise Hallelujah. You are able, Jesus. What can't you do? Hallelujah.
Creator of the universe, what can't you do? What can't you do? Name above every other name, what can't you change? What can't you change, Jesus?
You are able,
you are able, great and mighty God.
You are able,
Jesus.
You are able,
you are able.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and skies. Revival, we want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. Spirit, break out. Break your walls down. Spirit, break out. Heaven, come down.
Spirit, break out.
Spirit, break out. With praise, can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth.
Can you hear the sound?
The sound of heaven touching earth.
Our Father.
Our Father. All of heaven rose your name. Sing louder. Let this place erupt with praise. Can you hear it? The sound of heaven touching earth. The sound of heaven touching earth. King Jesus, you're the name we're lifted high. Oh, glory, shaking up the earth and skies. Revival, we want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here.
Spirit, break out.
Break our walls down.
We need you, Jesus.
Spirit, break.
Final song, hallelujah, because worthy is your name, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have to give the Lord some praise.
Hallelujah, for the Lord God Almighty reigns.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord,
hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Worthy is the Lamb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worthy is the Lamb this morning. Praise God. Praise God. Praise the name of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. For God is worthy of all our praise and all our honor and all our glory belongs to Him. Hallelujah. I want to thank our devotion team for leading us in such a world of worship this morning. Hallelujah. I want to also thank our musicians for accompanying us in worship. We also thank our technical team for providing these services. Hallelujah. For those who have just joined us, we want to welcome you. We are coming to you from the New Testament Church of God in Calder. I just want to welcome especially some people here that have joined us in this sanctuary. I want to recognize our brother Joseph. Welcome. You know we always welcome you here because we love you with a big, great Calder welcome and Calder love. We also like to welcome all the way from Belair, Miss Verisha Kennedy. Hallelujah. We thank you for worshiping with us this morning and also Karen John of Curtains. Kieran John from Curtains, yes. We want to welcome you and we thank you for worshiping with us. I would also like to point out one or two persons who have always been here with us. And sometimes we don't know, we don't recognize them, we don't even acknowledge their presence. But I like to recognize Brother Andrew in the back. Andrew, we love you. We really, really appreciate you. He's always here with us, even in our weekday services, weeknight services. And we'd also like to welcome our sister Margaret. Glad to have you, Sister Margaret, again. Really, really love you, brethren, for coming out at this time. Sister Black is here, yes. Sister Black, we welcome. I didn't even see you in the back there. Sister Black is Shirley's mom. Haven't seen you in a long time, Sister Black. It's good to see you here today. Thanks, Pastor. At this time, I'm going to call on our pastor. He's going to perform a service, this part of the service, and where we're going to receive into fellowship our brother, and Pastor will make that announcement when he comes. Let us welcome Pastor Carson Ferdinand as he comes. Pastor, we know that you are on vacation, but we thank you very much for breaking these 2 days of your vacation. I cannot give you back your 2 days, but God will reward you in the time when it comes. Thank you, Pastor.
Thank you, Minister Bacchus. And good morning, brethren. I am happy to be here this morning. I am thankful, I'm very grateful for the short vacation, the short rest. I know I really need it, but I'm extremely happy to be here this morning to receive the blessings from the Lord and to have fellowship with the brethren. God bless you, and it's nice to see all those that Minister Bacchus has mentioned. May God continue to bless you and to bless all the brethren, even those who are not with us this morning. We pray that God would meet them wherever they are. So at this time, I'm going to invite Brother Dimitri Nikki to come forward, please. Okay, Brother Nikki has professed faith in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and he was baptized in water yesterday. And he desires to have fellowship with the church. And so today we are going to receive him into the membership of the church. Sometimes when people come to the Lord, we often judge them and sentence them. But what God wants us to do is to receive them, give them the truth, and disciple them. And that is our responsibility. So we have to endeavor by the grace and help of God to help our brother to walk the walk of faith and to live a life that is pleasing unto God and to become his disciple and his witness in this world. So I am going to ask him some questions, and he will give the answers. Okay, so Brother Dimitri shared with us his wonderful testimony at the beach yesterday, and I'm going to ask him to turn around and face you and share with us his testimony this morning. Let's put our hands together for him. Praise the Lord. He's very excited and zealous after the things of God. Praise the Lord.
I want to thank God for a lot of things he has done in my life, for where he has brought me from to where I'm at today. There's nothing he has never given up on me, and do make sense I give up on him. I've been through a lot of bad times and seen a lot. Never turned to drugs, another thing, only alcohol I've done. Many other things. Fornication is not exemption. Yeah. I want to thank him a lot for everything he has done in my life. And I hope I could continue this journey as a strong believer in God, never to turn back. And enough sin is enough. I've done it all.
So now I will go through these questions with you, and for some of them you will say I do, and for some you will say I am, and I will indicate which one. You realize in presenting yourself for membership that you are assuming a solemn obligation, and it is expected that you will always be true to your promise and faithfully fulfill and discharge your obligation as a loyal member. To this first question, you would answer, I do. Do you publicly confess and testify that you know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior in the full pardon of your sins?
I do.
Next one is, I am. Are you willing to walk in the light of the scripture as it shines upon your path?
Of course I am.
Next one is I am. Are you willing to abide by and subscribe to the discipline of the Church of God as outlined by the scripture and set forth in the minutes of the International General Assembly?
I am.
I am also. Are you willing to abide by and subscribe to the discipline of the Church of God? Sorry, I'm reading the same one. Let me go on. The next one is I am. Are you willing to support the church with your attendance and temporal means? That means your material gains, your tithes and offering, and however the Lord blesses you. So let me go that again. Are you willing to support the church with your attendance, your temporal means, to the best of your ability as the Lord prospers you?
I am.
Next one is I do. Do you agree to be subject to the counsel and admonition of those who are over you in the Lord?
I do.
All right, thank you, Brother Dimitri. If there be any member who has a legal objection to any of these or to this person becoming a member of the Church of God, the objector may now so state. I'm waiting. Well, since we don't have any objections, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the Church of God, I take great pleasure in welcoming you into this membership and extending to you the right hand of fellowship. May I encourage you to call for the services of your pastor when needed. I have confidence that you will ever be a faithful member and a blessing to the church, and that the church will be a blessing to you. I pray our fellowship will always be bound together with unbroken love. Bow with me as we pray together, saints of God. Heavenly Father, I give you thanks and praise today. I thank you for this day that you have made. Your words declare that we must believe in our hearts and confess with our mouths, and we shall be saved. And our brother has done that today, and he has been obedient to follow you in the water of baptism. And today, Lord, we present him to you as our brother, as your child. I pray your blessing upon him in the name of Jesus, that you would sanctify him, O God. You would fill him up with your Holy Spirit, and you would give him that unquenchable thirst for you and for more of you. God, I pray that you would empower him, that he would walk the walk. He will not only talk the talk, but he will walk the walk. Lord, I pray that you would give him strength to overcome all temptation and to separate himself unto you and to live a holy life and unto God. Help him to continue to pursue you. Continue to seek your face, Lord. Continue to trust in you and to trust in your word and to explore all those avenues whereby he can grow in grace and that he will become a giant for you. Lord, I pray that he will become a great example of the power and grace of God. Lord, that he will have a greater testimony to share with the people of the world. Keep your hands on him, Lord. Wherever he goes and whatever he does, may he remain abiding under the shadow of your wings. I break all the power of the enemy, all the cycles in his life. Lord, all the bad habits in his life, I break them in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh God, you will uproot every tree that you have not planted. And oh God, you would give him, he would bring forth the fruits of the Spirit in his life. Every attack of the enemy, we come against it, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, wherever the enemy wants to attack, we put up a defense of the Holy Spirit, and that he will be victorious. Lord, he would be an example, he would be a light. Take full control of his life. And oh God, when the day comes, he would be found worthy to enter in with you. I give you thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You could stay right here. Okay, so we will sing the song, What a Fellowship, What a Joy Divine, and we'll give him a right hand of fellowship. I will go first, and I'll ask the council, the members of the council, to go with me, and then the rest of the brethren will come and give him a right hand of fellowship. Praise the Lord. What a fellowship. What a joy divine.
Fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all
the Lord. Thank you very much. And you can have your seat, Brother Dimitri. And we would now turn back to the moderator, Minister Backus.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, Pastor. Okay, this time we have the word, the message from the Lord. And there is no other person God has chosen for today to bring the word to us. I just want you to join with me as I welcome Brother Alston Kwame as he breaks the good news to us this morning. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. God bless you, Brother Kwame.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, church. God is good. Hallelujah. At this time, I want to call on Sister Peterson to say a prayer before. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we give you praise this morning because you are God and you are good. Father, we thank you because this morning we can give you praise. We are alive and we are well. Father, this morning, oh God, we bring Brother Kwame before you. Father God, the word that he's going to give to your people, may you come down and dwell with him, that your people may hear your word, oh God, and that we may be able to use it as a stepping stone in our lives, oh God. Father, this morning, we just touch him from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, oh God, that when he speaks this morning, oh God, you will be the one that will be speaking inside of him this morning, and all your people can be blessed by the word that he presents. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Praise God. Thank you, Sister Peterson. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. As you have heard the scriptures already this morning from Luke 6, 27, 28, and it said, "But I say unto you which hear, love your enemies, do good to them which hate you, bless them that curse you," hallelujah, "pray for them which despitefully use you." Praise God. Brethren, my message will be short. This morning I want to say to us, and I guess many of us know, I mean, loving our enemies is a hard thing to do. But God is saying to us, "But I say to you, which hear," he's saying to all of us who hear his word or who read his word. He said, "Love your enemies, do good to them which hate you." He said, "Bless them that curse you and pray for them." And brethren, and we know the enemy that we have today, the adversary. And also, we have some enemies, even in our homes, even in the schools, even in our workplaces, we have enemies. And sometimes, some of those people, they are the ones who make us their enemies. And sometimes when we get to realize the enemies that we are up against, sometimes we're shocked because we couldn't believe that that person was our enemy. But brethren, in the book of 1 Samuel, and we know the story with Saul and David. And David became Saul's enemy, not because David did anything wrong to Saul, but David became his enemy because of what he had achieved. And brethren, I want to say to us today that many of us are enemies to our brothers, to our sisters, in our workplace, in our homes, in our school, not because of we did something wrong to them, but because of your achievement. When David went out, when his brother went out to fight that giant, and David went after to see what they were doing. And when David looked, and David hear the word that that giant was saying about the God of Israel, David was saying, but who is this man that beating out such a cruel word, a cruel statement against the God of heaven? When all the soldier were backing down, and when he began to speak, he said, "I could go and fight that man and I could beat him. And King Saul was saying that this man is a fighter from his youth. And David used but a youth. But this man fight from his youth up. But I'm saying to us today, regardless of how great is our giant, I am saying we are serving a God that is greater than all the giants in our life. And we are, and he is greater than all the enemies that fighting against us. And David purposed within himself. He said, I could fight the giant. And that time we know the giant, and he was the enemy against the Israelites. And David purposed in himself. He said, I could fight him and I could destroy that enemy. Saul said to him, you are but a youth. But since you are so determined, you can go and fight him. And Saul gave him his armor and gave him all his protection. But David said, I cannot go with those things. They are too heavy for me. But I'm going in the name of the Lord. And David went out. And while he was going towards him, the giant began to say to him, you coming to fight with me? You look at me as a dog or some ordinary fowl or something, so you feel you can destroy me? But as the giant looked at David coming towards him, the giant advanced towards him and David was going. But praise God, this morning, God said he will never leave us and he will never forsake us. And all we have to do is just trust him and believe in him. And David go towards him and the giant began to make some threatening words. If you think he is a fowl, you think he whatever he is, and you're going to tear his body to pieces and give it to the birds and to the beasts of the field. And David said the same thing to him. And David said, you come to me with a sword and with weapon, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts. And David went out and David defeated him. My brother went today, my visiting friend, we can defeat every foe and every enemy in our life once we make Jesus the head of our lives. And the reason why David became Saul's enemy, after David destroyed the giant, he was still fighting war. And there comes a time when they was to go and fight against the Philistines again. And Saul sent David to fight because he said that was an excellent spirit was within him. The spirit of God was within David. Because if you notice, everything that David did, he was very successful. And David wasn't successful because of what he do and because he was a great fighter. He been successful because the spirit of the Lord was upon David. And when David went out and David fight, when he returned from his victory, brethren, we have to be very careful in this life that we are living. Like I said before, people hate us because of our achievement, and we become the enemy, not because of what we do to them. And the ladies, they came out, and they were singing and shouting. They come out to meet Saul, and they come out to greet him. And they were saying, Saul is 1,000. But David, his 10,000. I mean, that could be hurtful as a king. And you was a fighter for all your years. But here comes a young man. He just come on the scene. And here the ladies is coming out and shouting, Saul, his 1,000. And David, his 10,000. And the king get angry. And right there and then, David became his enemy. But the word of God tells us, we are to love our enemies. Pray for them. And in spite of everything, and everything that Saul did, and tried to defeat David, David was always victorious. The word of God tells us, even when Saul was trying to destroy David's lives, David had to flee, David run. At one time, both of them end up in the same cave. David was in the back of the cave, and Saul was in the front of the cave. I mean, this is a hard one. The man that you're looking for is in the same cave, and you lie down in the same cave, sleeping. Brethren, another thing I want to say to us today, when our enemy come up against us, we have to be very careful of our friends. Why I say that? Now David have his friends, his armies with him. They were fighting. And when they came out and realized that the very man who wanted to kill David was in the same cave, and he leave the cave and he went out. But before that, David take a piece of his skirt. He cut the skirt from off his robe. And when after Saul leave the cave and gone a distance, David came out after, and he was saying, and notice David was very, very careful and was obedient to the Lord. The men of his army wanted him to kill Saul. But David said no. He was chosen by God. And as the Lord liveth, I will not lay hand on him. Brethren, that's the reason why the word of God tells us we must love our enemy. Right there and then, you can see David had loved Saul still, in spite of Saul was his enemy. And Saul chose David, his enemy. But you notice that David wasn't studying about Saul to make him an enemy. Because if you notice, David spared his life. David could have killed him. He could have killed him. But David realized that the word of God tells us we have to love our enemies. We have to pray for them who despitefully use us. And sometimes in life, when you've been prosperous in this life, sometimes you struggle, you fight, you struggle. Sometimes you have sleepless nights. Sometimes you go without food. Sometimes you go half naked. And the reason why I say that, and you do it just to send your children to school. And brethren, when your children eventually begin to excel in life, people come back and make you the enemy. After all the sacrifice you made just for your children to be successful in life. Enemies, people choose us to be the enemies. Not because have we done something wrong to them, but God is saying to us, love your enemy. Brethren, it's not an easy task. For someone to do something wrong to you, sometimes someone come to tear you down to the lowest. Sometimes they degrade your reputation. They destroy your character. And brethren, it's not that easy task. Because like I always say, I will not trade my reputation not for all the riches in this life. Because brethren, when you have a bad reputation, doesn't matter what you have in this life, people don't look upon you. But I thank God today that we as Christians, we can stand up and we can say like the songwriter, oh my comrade, see that signal waving in the air. Reinforcement, victory is nigh. And brethren, when we have Jesus on our side, we will always be victorious. Another character that we can look at who have enemies without he do anything wrong to them. If you look at Daniel, in the book of Daniel, Daniel chapter 6, you don't have to really go to it. But when we read the book of Daniel, in Daniel chapter 6, we know Daniel was a man of prayer. And Daniel prayed 3 times a day. And Daniel found favor in God's sight, just like David did. And when the king started to do his research, he realized he wanted to choose men to put over his kingdom. And of all the men that he chose, he realized Daniel was more outstanding to put over his whole realms. And he chose Daniel. And all because of that, the other men choose to fight accusation to make Daniel their enemy. But I'm saying, when we trust God, when we put our confidence in God, they try to find all kind of accusation against Daniel. And one of them, you know what they said? We won't find nothing against this man. We won't find nothing against this man. This is a man who fears God, and whatever he do it accurately. All his bookwork, all his when he do all his inventory, everything was intact. So they couldn't find nothing against him. And they said, the only thing that we could find against him is about his God. And brethren, I'm saying to us today, thank God for Jesus. Thank God for Jesus. Jesus says, my deliverer, said the songwriter. And the writer said, how do you know? I know because he delivered me. And it's the same God that we are serving today. But the word of God is telling us, even though our enemy is on our back, come on. We must still love them and pray for them. Take care of them. If they're hungry, feed them. If they're naked, give them clothes. I mean, it's a hard task to do, but that's what God required of us as Christians. Feed your enemy. Give them drink. And even in the hospital, visit them. Show your face. Tell them that God loves them. That's the God we are serving. And they woke up everything against Daniel. But they realized that this man is an upright man. And everything they do, they just couldn't find nothing against him. And they said, the only thing is about his God. And what they do, some people are very subtle in life. They get the king, they go to the king and get him to write up, to sign up, to say that any man that they find making any petition against any other God or to any other God except to the king, they'll be thrown in the den of lion. But the king didn't realize what was happening. Not until, and Daniel, the word of God said, and listen, God's Holy Spirit had already revealed to Daniel what was going to happen. The word of God said, when Daniel realized and Daniel knew that that decree was signed, he go up in his room and he opened his window and he began to talk to his heavenly father. And when they came up and they saw him, they said, well, we got you now. But thank God this morning, Daniel was saying to God, he was speaking to God in some language, some heavenly language. Not even his enemy did understand. His enemy didn't understand. I believe Daniel was saying to God, God, my enemy is against me without a cause. And God is saying, you don't worry. I have everything under control. Brother, and when our enemies is against us and we stand up for God and be wholehearted to God, God have everything in control. And those men, they came up against Daniel and they go back to the king and they say, king, did you not sign this decree? Did you not seal it? And the king said, yes, that is true. And he said, you know, whenever you sign anything that you sign with the Medes and the Persians, it cannot change. The king said, yes, that is true. He said, why? And he said, that man, Daniel, whom you set over your realms, over your kingdom, he disobeyed you. And the word of God said, when the king realized what had happened, he vexed with himself. And he do everything. He said, the king fast. No music, no drink, nothing. He go through the whole night trying to save Daniel. But he realized he couldn't do it because he already signed to it. And brethren, today I'm saying to us, when we sign, when we make a signature to anything, we have to be very careful. Because sometimes when you sign something, if you ain't careful, we send away our life. We send away what we have. And then when you go to them, hear what they're saying, you didn't read the fine print. We have to be very careful. But with God, it's not so. With God, all things are possible. And the king said, okay. But notice, when they put Daniel into the lion's den, they rolled the stone. But notice what the king did. Because the king had confidence that the God that Daniel served will deliver Daniel. You can hear what he said to Daniel. He said, Daniel, the God whom you serve, he is able to deliver you. He's able. And I'm saying to us today, the God whom we serve, when people make us their enemy without a cause, he will deliver us. He will come to for us. And they throw him. But what the king did, The king take his own signet and he seal it. And also he take the signet of his ring and he seal it, that it will not change. And I believe, the Bible didn't say it, but I believe the reason why the king did that, the king had a plan, because he know Daniel will come out. And he know that those who accuse Daniel wrongfully, he's going to deal with them. But yet for all, the Bible said, we must love our enemy. The word of God said the king did to the whole night. He was fasting, no drinking, no music, nothing, trying to deliver Daniel. And the only man in the word of God said he run. And he said, Daniel, notice what he said. Daniel, servant of the Most High God. He says, the God you serve, able to deliver you. He said, king, live forever. He said, God has sent his angel to shut the mouth of the lion so they will not hurt me, so that they will not harm me. And the king gave the command that he should be taken out of the lion's den. And for all those who had accused Daniel, the word of God said they've been thrown into the lion's den, they and their families. We have to be very careful. Sometimes the thing that we do to other people, sometimes we cause our family to pay the price. Sometimes our family innocent, but because of what we do, we cause our family to suffer. Brethren, sometimes some of our family suffer, not by a lion tearing them to pieces, but the things that we do. As a father, I might do some wrong things. I messed up my reputation. I do some bad things in life. But because of that, when they see my son, when they see my daughter, they're going to say, she, that is so-and-so son, that is so-and-so daughter. Because of that, they suffer because of what I did. And so, in Daniel's case, those men who thrown him in the lion's den wrongfully, their families suffer. Their families suffer and they pay the consequence. But I'm saying to us today, my brethren, my visiting friends, it's a hard task to do. But the word of God said to us, we must love our enemy. We must treat them good. We must pray for them. Pray for them. Take good care of them. I mean, it's hard when you know somebody who hurt you. And sometimes some people go to length and breadth as to destroy you. As to destroy you, to put you down. They put you down. And sometimes when they finish, they go and they sit down with their friends and they laugh and they talk. You say, well, I got Minister William Joy once, you know. And that go for she. And they will say, I know that will happen. But later do they know. Later do they know that Minister Williams is serving a God who is well able. And while they were planning, all this tragedy, Minister William was saying, Jesus is my deliverer. Pastor Ferdinand was saying, Jesus is my deliverer. Sister Peterson was singing, Jesus is my deliverer. And before you know it, God, he come to for us and he deliver our family. Brethren, let us love our enemy. It's hard to do. It's a hard thing to do. But let us love our enemy. Sometimes, some of us carry around some stuff. Some of us carry around some stuff as human being and as Christian. It's not easy. I'm saying it's not easy. But I'm saying God will see us through. God will come true for us. Brethren, sometimes I get emotional because I know what God do for me. I know where he brought me from. Sometimes I go through some stuff. Brethren, I'm saying it to you. Sometimes I just feel like throwing the towel. I feel like give up. But God, his word said, I will never leave you. And I will never forsake you. Even in your trials, even in your hard times, even when you can't pay your bills, even when sickness is rampant in your life, I will never leave you. I will come to you for you. God, thank you, Jesus. Some of us have some stuff in our life that in Hebrews, in the book of Hebrews 12, he tells us that we must lay aside the heavy weight and the sin that easily beset us. Put them aside. Put them aside and strive and fight for Jesus. Brethren, I'm saying to us today, it's high time that we let go and we give up. And with Jesus, let Jesus hold on. where Jesus do the driving. It's time for us to come out of the driver's seat and put Jesus in the driver's seat and let Jesus drive for us. Because here why? Sometimes some of us, we are driving some big truck. And if we can't even say pull the steering. We can't manage it. We cannot turn the steering wheel. You know why? The truck is full of malice, envy, grudge. Name them. So much of thing is in the truck that we can't turn the wheel. So we have to give it over to Jesus. Because we can't manage it. Let's give it over to Jesus. And when we give it over to Jesus, Jesus will come true for us. Will give us a different heart. Sometimes when you say, Brother Kwame, what you mean, must give us a different heart. Sometimes the heart that we have sometimes is so messed up. It's so messed up. That's the reason why God said, sometimes you see a person going, look so handsome, look so beautiful. That is on the outside. That is the outside look. That is the outside appearance. But the word of God tells us that God look at the inner man. He look at the inner man, not the outer man. And many of us get carried away today. And many of us get tricked about the outer man, the way the outer man look. But inside, it's terrible. But God sees through our heart. He sees through us. And God is saying to us, Brother Kwame, you're better than that. Brother Kwame, you're better than that. Even though somebody hurt you, and even they pull you down to the ground, it doesn't mean you have to get, it doesn't mean that you have to go back at them and get back at them and get even with them. Love them. Even if we are for the night, they come to your house door ponging and ponging. They need food. They need to rescue. Rescue them. I honestly believe when we come out and when you stand up for our enemies and try to help them, listen to me. The word of God said we go heap coals of fire upon their head. You know what they're saying? You mean everything I do to Minister Williams, still for all, Minister Williams still come at my rescue? Minister Williams still come to rescue me? Sister Peterson still come to rescue me? Minister Baca still come to rescue me? After all, I have debt to them. They never give up on me. They still stand up for me. But praise God, in spite of everything, in spite of all the struggles, in spite of all the fight our enemies fight against us, the songwriter said, I still have my joy. I still have my peace. I still have my hope. I'm saying to us today, let us love our enemy. Even when they want to destroy us. Even when they want to kill us. Sometimes some people make us the enemy for no reason. Over material things. Simple things. Because even in the book of 1 Kings 21, we read about Naboth and his God and his vineyard. And Ahab wanted his vineyard. Brethren, sometimes people hate us for little things. Little things people hate us for. Naboth have his vineyard, and Ahab wants his, he's saying to him, go to Naboth and said, well, give me the vineyard. So because it's near to my home, it's near to my palace. So I could get it for my use. If not, I can pay you the money's worth. Naboth said, no way it's going to happen because this is for my forefather. And I'm going to keep it. I'm going to keep it. This is for my forefather. I'm not going to glory with it. Not for all the money. And the word of God tells us that Ahab got angry. He went home, sad. And his wife came up. Why are you sad? Why are you not eating? And why you are not drinking? He said, I went to Naboth and asked him for his garden and he refused. And he tell me some harsh words. Jezebel said, but you forget. You forget you're the king. You forget you have ranks. All you have to do is just make some phone call. All you have to do is just write up something. But he didn't do it. But Jezebel did it. She did it. She go and she said to him, you don't bother. Get up. Eat and drink. Be merry. I will take care of things. And I will see that you get the vineyard. And she went out And she began to write letters. She wrote them and used the king stamp. Let me say a stamp. And he stamped it and he sent them out to get men to accuse. To accuse an innocent man. To accuse Nebat. To said Nebat blasphemed against God and the king. And they took him out and they stoned him to death. Some people make us the enemy for no reason, for some simple things. And not only make us our enemies, but they kill us. They kill us just to achieve something that you have that doesn't belong to them. And when all been said and done, when it went out, so the men and they accused him. They took him out and they stoned him to death. And the word went back to Jezebel. He said, it's done. It's done. Nebat been taken care of. And he died already. He's stoned to death. Jezebel said, Ahab, Nebat's garden is yours now. Go and achieve it. Go and take it. It's yours. You don't have to fight. But go achieve it. But thank God for Jesus. We are serving a God who always comes before us. And the writer said, although he was 4 days late, he was on time. So God's timing always right. I honestly believe what happened to Nebat, God could have stopped it from happening. But here comes Ahab walking into the garden. But praise God, God speak to Elijah and said, go down and stop. Stop him. Stop Ahab from going to the garden to achieving his garden. And he went and he spoke to him and his countenance changed. And he's sick and the way he get on. But he said, I'm going to deal with all of Nebat's enemy. I'm going to take care of them. So sometimes our enemies trying to destroy us. But when we stand up, God take care of our enemy. He takes care of our enemies. Brethren, it's a hard task to do, like I always say. It's not easy to love your enemy. It's not easy. Sometimes you're in your home, and somebody break into your home, and they take everything that you have. They even try to kill you. They try to kill you. Sometimes they rape your daughter, they kill your wife, they kill your daughter, they kill off your whole family. And that's what the enemy does. But here comes, they put him in prison. 5 years, and out he came. And then you are to contend with him. And lo and behold, you go and meet him. You meet him in the hospital struggling. He's struggling for life. When you look at him, you within yourself, you say, but this is the man who killed my whole family. And your thing is to pass him straight, go by your business, because that's my enemy. That's a wicked man. But God, you know what's best. He said, love your enemy. Love your enemy. Brethren, it's not an easy task, but it's the will of God. That's God's will, and that's a command from him. Love your enemy. Those who despitefully use you. He said, pray for them. He said, pray for them. Even if it means you have to pay the bills, pay the bills. My God. Your enemy, pay the bills. Sometimes they're in a condition. Sometimes you have to go and lift them up. The condition they're in is so messed up, but you still have to go and lift them up, take them and carry them. Carry them from one place to the next place after all that they have done to you. And brethren, it's not an easy task, loving an enemy. But when we do that, oh my God, sometimes it's not that easy task to do, to love your enemy. When sometimes when you sit down, you shut your eyes, sometimes you're actually seeing all the things that you have done wrong to you. And you're asking yourself the question, must I really do this for this man or this woman? But the word of God said, love them, regardless of what. Love your enemy. Take care of them. Sometimes in the wee hours of the night, you just lie down to sleep. The name, you and the thing of it, Some of them is so bold face. They come and they call in your name. They're shouting out. They destroy you. But now that their time come to get destroyed, they don't want to be destroyed. They need all the help they can. They need all the help they can get to survive. But when they were destroying you and I, they never need any help. They didn't see us that we need help. They didn't see that we need mercy and we need compassion. But when their time comes around, they need all the mercies they can get. And they need all the compassion they can get. Brethren, it's not an easy task to love your enemy. But the word of God said, we are to love them. We are to love them. And sometimes, when you study back where God said in his words, when the time comes, when the time is right, and he said, I never knew you. I never knew you. When a man is hungry, didn't feed him. When a man naked, didn't feed him. When he want clothes, didn't clothe him. And sometimes this said man with Jesus is talking about, you know, he's the enemy. We refuse to give the enemy food. We refuse to give him a drink of water. We refuse to give him clothes. And Jesus sees it that we refuse to do it. Because why? His word tells us to love our enemy. When they hate us, when they despitefully use us, we must pray for them. Pray for them that they could get good health. Pray for them that they could live well. Pray for them that they could meet their demands, meet their needs. Pray for them that they could pay them bills. Pray for them that their family could get a good schooling. After all they've done, they hate you for nothing. They destroy you for nothing because you fight and you struggle. And then they said, how daughter pray will not be? After you fight so much, after you struggle so much, and your daughter make it. They are nice when you're down on your knees. You're shouting and you're calling to God for help. Because hear me, the school fee is about to pay and you don't know where the last dollar coming from. But you're down on your knees and you're fighting. You're fighting. One man said one time, he said, brother, sometimes I go into work, you know. And I mean, I go into work, I have my clothes on, and he said, above my pants, you're seeing like a jockey waist. You're only seeing the waist, but the other part, I want to tell you about it. It's serious. This is serious business. I mean, that is what is called sacrifice. That is what you call sacrifice for your children to survive and to get a good education. But yet, the enemy comes back and wants to destroy you. The enemy comes back and wants to destroy your sons and your daughters after you fight so much and struggle to help them. And still coming back and say, I wish you play. I wish you play. It's not what I playing. It's not what you're playing. But it's what God bring you through. You fight and you struggle. God understands. He hears you when you call. He sees your tears and he understands. And he came to for you. And to the date, you can stand. And you can lift up your hand anywhere you go. And tell the man and the woman on the street, wherever you go in your workplace, that Jesus is my deliverer. He is my deliverer. Brethren, and I'm saying it today from experience because I know what God done for me. I know where he brought me from. And like I said before, sometimes I get very emotional. Because sometimes some of us, when God sees us through, when God comes to for us, when we finish, we turn our back on God. After all he has done for us, after all God done for us, after God fight down all our enemies, after God push us aside and take over the fighting and fight for us and give us the victory, we turn our back on him. But my brethren, my visiting friends this morning, in closing, I want to say to you all, and I'm saying to myself, God said we must love our enemy. Let us love them. It's a hard thing to do. It's very hard to do. If they need a drink of water, give them the water. If they need food, feed them. But I'm saying to us today, Let us love our enemy in Jesus' name. Thank you. Toma, back to the moderator.
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for that message this morning and thank Brother Kwame for allowing God to use him. And it's a very difficult task that Jesus has left with us, that we must love our enemies. But God makes everything possible for us to do. We just have to follow him in his commandments and everything that he has given us to work with.